She was wrong. She was stunned when she heard him rummaging through her kitchen. He started opening the refrigerator and rattling pots and pans. And then he'd come back in. He'd tell us, "Don't move or I'll come back and kill you." After hours of torment, the attacker finally left, and the young mother was able to free herself from her bondage. I was finally able to get the blindfold off, and then whispered to my son, I said, James screamed for help, and a neighbor contacted police. Detective Carol Davis responded to the 911 call. Jay Carson was severely traumatized. What do you remember about your conversation? Jane was a professional person. She was a nurse. She was a captain in the Air Force Reserve, but she was in shock. It was like disbelief as to what had just happened to her. Investigators found fireworks on a window that appeared to have been the intruder's point of entry. Then, Jane mentioned that her home had recently been burglarized. He took my son's piggy bank and my driver's license. Police concluded that the same man had been responsible for both crimes. He was in the house 2 weeks earlier. The evidence indicated that Jane's attacker had been stalking her for weeks before the assault. Investigators collected the shoelaces that had been used to bind Jane and her son. But unfortunately, there was little else to go on. Were investigators able to find any evidence in her home? The fingerprint, because it was left. And since the man had been wearing a ski mask, the young mother was only able to provide a vague description of her attacker. I would say he was probably my age or possibly a little younger, maybe 6 foot. As detectives analyzed Jane's story, they began to notice frightening similarities to 4 other sexual assaults on the east side of Sacramento. Each of those women had been attacked in her home by a man wearing